this video, I'm going to show you how to stop trips tied in Madden 22, or at least a very good starting point for defending what I would argue against anybody is probably the best offense in this game. You're going to see a lot of pro players are switching to trips tight end. Trips tight end is definitely getting better every single day, especially as we kind of reach this point in Madden where you have receivers that can get some separation man-to-man, or you've got some ability to be able to roll out of the pocket and manipulate zone coverage. And so in this video, like I said, we're going to talk about how to kind of contain trips tight end a little bit, or at least a really good starting point for that. Now, if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I upload new Madden videos every single day that can help you take your Madden game to the next level. I also want to let you know that in this video, we're specifically going to focus in on the nickel normal defensive formation. You can find this in particular formation out of the San Francisco 49ers defensive playbook. The San Francisco 49ers defensive playbook, in my opinion, has probably the best combination of defense as well as coverage concepts that you can apply from formation to formation. So I actually did a whole defensive ebook on this defense here, the nickel normal. So if you want to get access to that, there's going to be a link down below. If you want to get the full defensive ebook, we show you how to stop bunch trips, U-trips, tight, all of the meta offenses in this game with the nickel normal, and also kind of give some explanation as to why I think the nickel normal for right now and where the game's at right now is the best defense in the game, primarily because of where we're heading in terms of it being a little bit more of a coverage meta as opposed to a heavy blitzing meta. So with all that in mind, if you want to check out the ebook, it's down in the description. We're going to be talking today about the cover three buzz match week. That's the defense we're going to come out in, and really we're only going to make one adjustment. I guess technically we're going to make three adjustments. I don't know, 3 to 5 adjustments. There's only one adjustment you really need to make, and then I'm going to show you some that you can make. So PA counter go, like I said, pound for pound, one of the better plays in the game. And it's because of this deep crossing route to the slot. Now, trips tight end, if you think about the way the offense works, probably 80% of the offense kind of runs through the tight end and the inside slot in the trips. Those are the two receivers that really get a lot done for the offense. And so how we're going to combat this is we're just going to pinch our defense. We're going to crash our D-line out. And then we want to user this guy right here, Gilman. Okay, that's going to be our primary user defender. And essentially what we're looking to do is if the tight end runs a post route to the left side, we're going to cover him. That's pretty much all we have to cover. Either the tight end coming across the formation or the running back coming across formation. Those are our two primary guys that we're going to need to cover. So we're going to pinch our defense. We're going to crash our D-line out. We're going to spy both of our defensive linemen. If you want to, you can put the defensive tackle on the left side into a three reg. I would really recommend blitzing your user. So you see, it kind of looks like this. This is kind of the basic blitz. But the key adjustment that you really need to do is you need to take this safety on the right side of the screen and put him into a inside quarter zone. Okay, he wasn't a hook curl, but we're going to put him in an inside quarter zone. And what you're going to see is it's going to basically kind of tell that defender that he is now responsible for the number three receiver in the trips, which is Chris Godwin. So Chris Godwin runs a crossing route, that inside quarter is going to go guard him. If Chris Godwin runs a corner route to the left side, that inside quarter is going to go guard him. All right, imagine if we cross-manned him, but you're going to see it's a very manipulative and very just kind of secret little coverage adjustment, and you see how good this guards the crosser. Absolutely takes away the crosser. Now, if we jump into instant replay here, I want to show you how the rest of the defense works. What we've got here is we've got, because of the spy and because of the three rec, we've got pretty decent coverage on the running back. We also have seam flats on both sides of the field, so we're going to be okay. Seam flats actually do a really good job, in my opinion, on little flat passes and things like that. Our primary responsibility on this play right here is going to be this dig route. So you see we're going over here to the dig, but everything else is completely bagged, as you can see, and the defense plays very, very well. All right, so we're really kind of, if you think about it, we basically are playing the hook curl, right? We're playing in this little box, and if we have to carry that tight end vertical, we can. So let me show you another popular route combination that you'll see from time to time. If someone knows what they're doing out of trips tight end, it's very possible you're going to see a combination that basically looks like this right here. So we're going to do the exact same adjustments. I like to pinch my defense, crash my line out. I'm going to QB spy both of my defensive linemen. If you want to put one of them in a three rec, you can do that. That is fine. I would recommend putting the guy on the side of the trips into that three rec. What I mean by that is you're putting him in a bluff blitz. So that's the adjustment. And then we inside quartered the right of screen safety. So now you see here's the coverage. And now what we're going to do is we're going to kind of come over here. And as you see, tight end's coming across, so we're going to take him. But everything else is pretty much bagged up. Okay, let me jump into instant replay and show you this concept. And then we're going to show you kind of the concept that a lot of trips tight end players like to save for critical moments. I'm going to show you two more concepts and show you how this works. So you see here, see how that slant and the seam flat kind of work together to guard that? Now, it's a tight window. You might be able to fit that in, but it's not an easy throw. And if we wanted to, we could just put that defender in a curl flat, or we could, you know, there's things we could do. We could carry that slant a little bit more. But you see there, I mean, that's pretty good defense. And then we're just lurking the tight end, as you can see. Okay. Now, another popular concept that people like to run out of this is the curl flat play. The curl flat play, and why they like to do this is because that deep post route from the slot is going to get over the top of any kind of zone drop. So if you're putting your zone drops at 30, this is going to do a good job at combating that. All right, so we're going to do the exact same adjustment that we've been doing the entire time, and we're going to always open up and take this snap throwaway. Then we're going to come back down here, and as you see, it matches onto that post really, really well, and it kind of baits this curl. This curl route, honestly, is one of the more riskier throws. Last year, I think that was actually a better throw. You'll see this little seam flat. Watch it bait the curl. See that right there? Most people throw that curl flat as a check down. Obviously, I'm over in that area too. So, I mean, it's really not that big of a deal. And you can see we don't have to really guard the running back route. Like, from right here, we can come over here a little bit more to the wide side. We don't really have to guard that running back route really at all, but, like, right in there maybe. And, I mean, again, if they really wanted to thread a needle, the curl flat route might be there for them. But, you know, eventually we're going to pick stuff like that off. All right? So now I want to go to kind of an additional concept that you're going to see a lot, and that is this. So once they start to see that you're taking away their crossing routes or their flooding concepts to that other side, now what they're going to do, what you'll notice, is they're going to start trying to flood the trip side. And so, again, same exact adjustments. As you can see, our responsibility is the middle of the field here. So at the snap of the ball, we're going to come over here. Once we see this, we can feel free to let it go. And look at how good of a job that inside quarter will do against that corner route. That's actually, I think, super, super underrated about this defense. So just to illustrate this, I'm going to actually take control of the offensive side of the ball to try to show this a little bit better. But what's going to happen is they're going to try to throw this corner route. I can guarantee you that's what they're going to try to do. Now, we don't want that safety to do what he just did. That's kind of a random deal. What I would really like to do is put the safety kind of right in here. If you want to kind of bring him down a little bit, just bring him down kind of in that area. It gives him a really good positioning. And now that's going to look open. But you see how he kind of baits it, and you can click onto that and come underneath it and pick it. So this is just one of my favorite concepts in the game. And then one last thing I want to show you real quickly here. This is something you need to be aware of because you are in a cover three shell. I do want to show you one of the things. So and that is a bomb concept out of trips tight end that I put together. And this concept is really, really good for beating cover three. But what you're going to notice is this in particular, cover three, that deep third will oftentimes get back on that. Obviously, that concept to me is probably the most difficult one. And there's ways that we could combat that. We talked about that in our Nickel Normal ebook. But when you mix in some, you know, maybe some Tampa 2 or maybe mix in some quarters along with what we're doing out of cover three, maybe even just mix in like some cover one robber. Very, very tough defense, I think, against trips tight end. You know, one of the things you could do, just kind of spitballing here with you, but one of the things you could do here, and let me see if I can, I'll do it out of Overstorm Brave. It's a little bit better of a defense to show this. So we can go to Overstorm Brave, right? And what we could do is we could put an inside third or a curl flat out of that coverage. Then we could put an inside quarter because we know that all we've got to do is kind of carry this slot until that quarter zone is going to go guard it. Everything else is pretty much man locked. And then what we can do with this guy right here is now we can still do kind of some of our underneath stuff, but now we can get a little bit more aggressive in terms of how this hard flat is going to play. And now what you'll see here is something like a standard four verticals concept even. I mean, it doesn't really matter what it is. But now, I mean, you're just kind of opening here. Then you can pass that off, and you see, look how good of an adjustment that is for how it's going to defend the trip. So, anyways, that's just one of my favorite little adjustments. I've talked about it a lot this year, but I think it's really a very, very good adjustment for defending this formation, because the whole formation really does run through that player. And if you can slow that guy down, then you can kind of use the rest of your defenders to lock things up. So I want to thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about this defense and a little bit of the finer details, how you can mix in pressures with this and other coverage schemes for this, I would really encourage you to join my Patreon. My Patreon is only $10 a month. And for just $10 a month, you're going to get access to everything. We've got 13 offensive and defensive schemes available for you over at the Patreon membership as soon as you sign up, and we've got more on the way. We typically post a new ebook in there every 1 to 2 weeks. And so, guys, if you're really looking to take your Madden game to the next level, I would really encourage you to sign up for that Patreon membership. There's a link in the description below, and you can get signed up for that today. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you want to join the Patreon, head on down to the description and click that link.